You have probably used this phone before, the BlackBerry. And if not, then perhaps the Nokia. Both companies ruled the world with their mobile phones, but today they don't exist anymore in the way they used to. Their phones were great, but they seriously underestimated the impact from their new competitor, the iPhone. The phone market is just one example, but I could also take bookstores, travel agencies, navigation software, etc. The big five are slowly taking over the entire world. Over the past few years, big tech companies have also started to show interest in the pharmaceutical industry by taking over pharma companies or collaborating with them. It seems like the pharmaceutical industry will be their next target. So, why have these big tech companies their eyes on the pharmaceutical industry? We'll dive into what has happened so far and what we can expect from them in the future. My name is Amar and I'm one of the founders of PharmaOffer, an online B2B platform for pharmaceutical ingredients. I admit, it's a tech company as well, but our pockets are nearly as deep as those of the big five tech companies. First of all, who are the five big tech companies? I don't think they need any introduction. The big tech companies are becoming more powerful every day. Together, they own hundreds of other companies and have millions of employees. These companies are dominating several markets like social media, online advertising, cloud services, operating systems, video streaming, smart home, payment solutions, and so on. And I can tell you, they're still hungry. Why is pharma interesting to them? In the first place, you don't see many similarities between the pharmaceutical industry and these tech companies, but they see it differently. In fact, there are three main reasons why they want to enter the pharma market. It's a huge market. The entire pharmaceutical industry is a $1.25 trillion market. To give you an idea how much that is, it's a lot. If they manage to get just a slice of this market, it is already a major success. Secondly, big tech companies are really rich. They are all listed on the stock exchange and their shareholders expect them to grow at all times. They have lots of resources to aggressively take over existing players, which makes entering new markets easier. Besides money, they have a large network, their brand awareness, and they can use their existing platforms to promote or incorporate their new activities. Thirdly, the pharmaceutical industry is lagging behind when it comes to digital innovation. From a digital point of view, the pharma industry is still an undiscovered market. Big tech companies understand what it takes to digitize an entire industry. You can almost say that they did it before. They know, for example, how to collect, use, and convert data into better customized products and services, or use digital tools to streamline the entire supply chain. What's going on? I'm not speculating here. In fact, they made their first moves already. Google has recently started a cooperation with Sanofi, where they use Google's knowledge and power in artificial intelligence for new drug discovery in innovative ways. Microsoft has teamed up with Novartis, where they also use artificial intelligence for discovering, developing, and commercializing new drugs. And Amazon has acquired PillPack, an online prescription service for over $750 million. And this was just the beginning for them, as in November 2020, they've launched an online pharmacy in the USA. Amazon is even offering Prime members a discount when they buy medicines at their online pharmacy. Here you can see an example of how to connect newly acquired services with an existing client base. And it doesn't mean they will focus only on acting as a distributor for pharmaceuticals. For their regular e-commerce products, they use their data to target the most profitable products and make a private label that you might know as Amazon Basics. In doing so, they control the entire supply chain for those products, both B2B and B2C. Can we expect them to have the same plans for APIs and medicines? What can we expect? The positive side is that they will bring innovation to the market, which will in the end improve global healthcare. Besides that, they will challenge traditional pharma companies to innovate as well. The downside is that it will make them even more powerful than they already are. the global population will become too dependent on them. Many big tech services are freely accessible for everyone. And nowadays, if something is for free, you'll pay with your privacy, and that's not okay within the pharma healthcare industry. How should pharma companies respond? Pharma companies should take them seriously. Tech companies are doing some incredible things like building affordable self-driving cars, smartphones where you can literally do anything you can imagine on, showing three-dimensional images of the entire world in detail, and so on. Also, their manpower is too big to ignore. To give you an idea, we recently launched a video of the top 10 pharma companies with the most employees. Johnson & Johnson is the proud winner with more than 135,000 employees. Amazon, however, has over 1.1 million employees. We shouldn't assume that the pharma industry is too challenging for them. I would recommend investing in innovation within your company. Not just catching up with your website, but for example, significantly improve the supply chain or your customer experience. So the last thing I'd like to say is, don't be the pharmaceutical BlackBerry. I hope you liked the video. Do you think big tech companies will be dominant players in the next 5 years within the pharma market? Would love to hear your opinion in the comments below. We always appreciate it if you hit the like and subscribe button. Stay safe and enjoy your day.